Team Trees, YouTubers collaborating with each other in order to raise funds to plant 20 million trees around the world. It's an awesome cause and you should definitely donate as much as you can. Though I would like to raise the question, could $20 million be better spent? Say by giving those new Tesla trucks to 399 random people and one specific person. Because let's face it, trees just sit there. None of them regale you with stories like in the old Nandan comics, and the memes are barely a 5 out of 10. The Cybertruck, on the other hand, is probably just a couple of software updates away from becoming Megatron. So let's pit them against each other to see which gives you a better bang for the buck in terms of saving the environment. We'll go with a quick-growing tree that reaches its mature weight of 2 tons in 10 years. A tricked-out F-150 four-wheel drive emits 6.25 metric tons of carbon dioxide if you drive it 20,000 kilometers a year. Let's save all that carbon by replacing it with a Cybertruck. So 20 million trees versus 400 Cybertrucks. Ready? Get set, go!
Day 1. The Cybertrucks are off to a good start. Using the high torque typical of electric cars, they race ahead, reducing carbon emissions by 7 tons. The Baby Groot army, on the other hand, can only suck up a paltry 30 kilos.
Ha! Environment hippies. Thinking nature could stand a chance against hardcore electric technology.
By the end of the week, the Teslas maintain their lead with 48 tons of carbon dioxide emissions, with Baby Groots on 10. At 2 weeks, the Teslas are only ahead by 14 tons.
What?
The lead has disappeared as the trees grow taller. And it gets worse. 1 month on, the trees have sequestered 4 times more carbon dioxide than the Cybertrucks. By 1 year, nature has built up an insurmountable lead on technology, which continues to stretch.
And over 10 years of the Cybertruck's useful life, they get absolutely crushed by the trees. The signs were there all along. Paper beats rock. So I guess it's over. Good riddance. Never liked that design anyway. But wait, trees are alive. So trees die. And as they die, they decompose and release the carbon dioxide right back into the environment. If you think that I'm off base, just take a look at this article, which details how Canada's forests, far from absorbing carbon dioxide, actually emit it.
So as the trees die off in the year 2115, the Cybertrucks lying in a scrap heap somewhere flash their LEDs in triumph one last time.
But before you get to your guitar and start writing country songs about the pickup truck that refused to quit, remember, 100% of our electricity does not come from renewable sources either. It's only about 35%.
So diving into this table on our energy production carbon footprint, we are left with 7,500 metric tons, which defers the Cybertruck's victory to 2131.
And we still haven't taken into account the carbon emission involved in manufacturing the Cybertrucks. A large battery, like the one in the Cybertruck, will add an additional 17.5 tons of carbon dioxide to the manufacturing process. So over a 10-year life cycle, we're down from 25,000 to...
only 884 tons of carbon dioxide saved over 10 years for all 400 Cybertrucks. The lesson here is that EVs make a lot of sense, but only if your country's power supply is not fossil fuel dependent. The good thing is, the entire world is headed in that direction. Over a reasonable timescale, say 100 years, the trees win, though only around 5,000 survive to celebrate the fact. Even at its peak, the Team Trees campaign is only likely to sequester around 12.5 million tons of carbon dioxide.
That sounds good, until you realize India's carbon footprint was 2,300 million tons last year. So are there any good solutions out there? What about pulling carbon dioxide directly out of the air, like some people have suggested? A technology called direct air capture by Climeworks is extracting 900 tons of carbon dioxide per annum in Sweden. So just 3 million of them and we'll be sorted. It's so impractical that Howard Herzog of MIT called the whole technology a sideshow, estimating that it would cost $1,000 per ton of carbon dioxide. Not gonna work. Though I'll link their website if you feel like burning your money and want to make a donation to people whose heart, at least, is in the right place. Looks like trees are the best carbon suckers we have. Perhaps in the future, cheap, limitless energy from fusion will make these technologies possible. Or free energy from the cosmos. Maybe there's a way to drag that out of the quantum zoo. Or you know what? Maybe global warming is a hoax after all. Carbon dioxide levels were many times higher in the past than they are today. And there has been a pause in global warming for quite a while anyway. It's all the sun, you see. Us tiny little humans couldn't possibly affect a system as large as the climate. Al Gore did us all a big disservice with his exaggerations. It gave people ammunition to question the conclusions of climate scientists and call everyone concerned about climate change an alarmist. And for what it's worth, I don't think movements like Extinction Rebellion are helping the cause either. the Earth's temperature is rising, and I do believe humanity's use of fossil fuels is the cause. But the economics of doing something or nothing are both so great that we will argue about it for decades to come. So what do I think about team trees? Sometimes there are problems and obstacles that are way too vast in scale for humanity. And the best we can do is make a gesture. One that we may know could be futile in the final reckoning, but something that could help unite us against a common enemy. Trees are good for a lot more than just carbon sinks. They give fruit, shelter, prevent erosion, and connect climate activists and skeptics alike to a primordial sense of peace. Even if we do someday become compressed layers in the rocks for future civilizations to discover, let them at least wonder and speculate about the magnitude of flora that bloomed at the very end. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Like, share, and subscribe to get more content and coupons like this in your recommendations. I'll see you really soon. Bye.